The card you see here is an entry-level GPU from the first ever DX9 series, released by ATI, now known as AMD, released in late 2003, making this card exactly 18 years old at this point. The model of the 9550 is somewhere of a specific one, since it features 64 MB more VRAM than the usual model, and it is of a type known as GDDR memory, as opposed to the DDR memory used on the classic model. It also has a 128-bit memory bus, which is yet again double the bandwidth of the normal GPU. So with such kind of horsepower under the hood, we should test it out and see how well it performs in the titles of that era. We need a CPU to accompany this card alongside today's journey. So a 2.6 GHz Pentium 4 from the same time period comes into play, alongside a whole gigabyte of DDR1 memory, which will be more than enough for the kind of operating system people were used to run in the early 2000s, which is none other than the legendary Windows XP. So without wasting any more time, let's move on to the gaming benchmarks. So first up is a classic from 20 years ago, namely Return to Castle Wolfenstein, running on the highest settings with 720p resolution, and doing so pretty well, but that was kind of expected and not much of a surprise, considering that the game was 3 years old at the point of this card's release. Regardless of its age, I would really recommend this one to anyone who hasn't played it before, as it is a real classic and still very enjoyable after all these years. Next up we have Fable The Lost Chapters, a very good looking but quite demanding game, which shows in the performance figures. So if you want to play it on this card, you need to reduce the settings to the absolute minimum to just get a stable 720p gaming experience. So it's not that bad, but not that great either. One of the most popular games of the decade was Half-Life 2. And if you had a 9550 GE back in the day, you could just about squeeze out a close to playable performance. But expect a lot of stutters and slowdowns when entering any more demanding areas of the game. So you would have needed something slightly more powerful in order to run the legendary Half-Life 2 back in the day. To finish off today's benchmark list with a disaster, The Elder Scrolls Oblivion was a real mess running on this card. Even with the absolute minimum settings the game allows, there were quite a lot of problems as seen with the footage on screen. So I guess we found the limitation of this card, which is set to a maximum of up to 2005 games. Everything after that is just a real torture for this card. DirectX9 set the foundation for many graphical masterpieces during the next 10 years of its existence, bringing us games like Far Cry 3 or 2013's Tomb Raider. All of these are very good looking games, even when ran in the respectable DirectX9 mode. But the 9000 series of GPUs was where it all started, and although these cards are more than obsolete nowadays, it is nice to see where the technological advancements of the early 2000s led us throughout the next decade. And who knows, maybe one day we will look back at the first DirectX 12 card and have similar thoughts.